Hello viewers, welcome to this special show. India is moving in a very crucial phase, and union budget has a predominant role in this phase. And if you talk about union budget, taxation is the most important aspect. So to discuss on this taxation and also the issues related to this, we have with us the Revenue Secretary of the Government of India, Dr. Hasmukh Adhia. Hello sir, welcome to this special show. So before we discuss about the taxation and these issues, could you please give a brief overview of the broad structure of the direct and indirect taxes in India, sir?
Our total tax revenue projection for the current year is 14.4 lakh crore.
Yes.
So we can call it 14.5 trillion rupees. Now, out of this, the income tax is about 8 lakh crore,
yes.
And the indirect tax is about 6.5 lakh crore. If you see the composition of direct tax, there are two parts, corporate income tax and the personal income tax. The corporate income tax is about 59% and the personal income tax is about 41%.
Yes.
If you talk about the indirect tax, there are three major taxes, excise duty, customs and service tax. Hmm. Each one of them normally contributes about 33% equal amount.
Right.
But of course, this year, because of the oil excise duty, the structure is slightly skewed. We will have about 39% coming from excise duty and the remaining from the other two. The structure of our indirect tax is a little bit skewed when it comes to customs duty and the excise duty. If you take the top 10 items in excise duty, they contribute about 75% of the revenue, only 10 items, yes, in excise duty. And in case of custom duty, of course, it is about more than 60% is coming from top 10 items. But when it comes to the service tax base, it is quite diversified. Hmm. So that is one thing good about the service tax structure that we have.
Right. Yes. So when we talk about the indirect tax and direct tax separately, Nav, the indirect tax, actually there is a robust mop-up we could actually see in the complete figures. But then when we come back to the direct tax, there is a slightly, it is slightly lower, it is just the 65% of the target. If you can analyze this, where exactly the things have to be placed?
Well, we must agree that because of various reasons, the corporate earnings have not been very robust this year.
Yes.
The profitability of companies are affected, and main part of our income tax is 60%, 59% comes from corporate income tax.
True.
So it's because of this reason that we are seeing that the growth in income tax is about 11% so far, 11% growth compared to last year, while in case of indirect tax, it is 33%. The growth in indirect tax is 33%. So far, the trend is something like this. We would be probably missing out on our target when it comes to direct tax. We would be short by about 40,000 crore in direct taxes, but we would have equal amount coming as an extra amount from indirect tax. So on the whole, this year we hope to achieve the target.
Right. And you were mentioning about the customs duty revenue as well, sir. It actually looks pretty much bright. How would these indications should be understood from the investments point of view?
Well, I see a lot of silver lining in the indirect tax revenue. For example, in banking and financial services, the growth rate in service tax has been almost 45%, which is quite high.
True.
Then there has been an indication in the custom duty of machinery. It has gone up by 25-30%. Now this all indicates that there is a substantial amount of economic activity which is now building up.
True.
So from indirect tax, I do have these indications. Hmm.
And we talk about this complete reaching the target, sir. Government had, in fact, invariably had fallen in the previous years. They couldn't reach this tax collection target, but now it actually is successfully in a position to reach the targets. Where exactly has the difference erupted, sir?
Well, I would like to say that the God has also helped us in terms of falling crude revenue price. We have been able to have some extra space to levy some more taxes and excise on petroleum products, because of which we are comfortable today. But yes, it is for the first time probably in last 5 years that the BE target will be met.
Right. And there is a lot of focus on widening of tax base. What does it really mean, sir? What are its long-term implications if we talk about
this? Well, basically, a lot of people say that the number of people who pay income tax in India is about 3-3.5% of the total population. But we can't count it like that. We have to see how many people are working out of the total population. So you can't tell me that 120 crore people, all of them, each one, even a bachcha, should pay income tax.
True.
But no doubt about it that this particular figure is low. We have been trying to widen our tax base, but there is a good news also. The good news is that because of the TDS provision which has been introduced,
yes,
a lot of people who are not filing their income tax return are also indirectly paying tax to the government in form of TDS.
Right.
And this is what is happening. So as a result of this, the figures are now looking very respectable. People are still sticking to the target of 3 crore people paying income tax. Not so. Let me tell you that about 3.5 to 4 crore people are now filing tax return, and the remaining about 1.85 crore to about 2 crore people, they are having some form of tax payment in form of TDS paid, and they don't come to us for filing the return. So the total number of taxpayers, you can say, has gone up to almost close to 6 crore now.
Right. And we are talking about the taxpayers, sir. In fact, there is a general perception that people don't actually mind paying the taxes. But the real problem that comes is they are wary of the administrative hassles and also the paperwork involved in it. How is the department planning to address this issue?
Well, yes, I do agree that nobody wants to mind paying the tax. But the question is that they want hassle-free tax administration. In this direction, the only way out for us is to use IT in a big way, which we have done. We have got a state-of-art central processing unit in Bangalore, which handles all the returns. This year, 90% of the income tax returns are filed online. And out of this, we have been able to process already, in the first 9 months of this year, we have been able to process 3.27 crore returns. They have been processed and decided, and the refunds have been given. And how many refunds are given wherever they were due? 1.81 crore people have got their refund in the first 9 months this year. And out of which, you would be surprised that 1.31 crore people have got their refund within 30 days of filing the income tax return, which is amazing for them.
Absolutely.
And we've got some very raving appreciation tweeters and comments on this.
Right. And so another initiative of the department is, I mean, that is actually being widely discussed about the phase out of these tax exemptions. What exactly you mean when you talk about these tax exemptions?
Well, you know, for various reasons, the government decides to give some tax exemption. It can be area-based exemption for backward area. It can be export-oriented units exemption. It can be the income tax benefit for special economic zone, SEZs. It could be accelerated depreciation for manufacturing sector. So all these various exemptions are given in indirect tax. And they cost us a lot of money. In fact, in direct tax, we are losing about 1 lakh crore in these exemptions. Now, the cause may be noble, but it distorts the taxation system. In case of indirect tax also, we are almost losing 1 lakh crore because of various exemptions given for SEZ, EOU, and other facility. So the question is, ki, had we not given all these exemptions, we would have been able to probably reduce the income tax rate. And we would have given a more fair deal to people in terms of paying the same thing. The exemptions create inequity. It creates an inequity between the existing unit and the new unit which is availing of the exemption. And it also creates inequity in terms of smaller companies and bigger companies. The bigger companies are paying much less effective rate of taxation compared to smaller companies. Why? Because they are able to avail of the exemption for various reasons, while the smaller companies are not availing of the exemption. Then certain manufacturing sector companies are paying more, paying less, while the service sector companies and the finance companies are paying more tax. So this kind of inequitous situations come, and in view of that, we have come out with a roadmap for phasing out of exemptions, and it was a draft map. This map will be finalized at the time of budget. How we are coming out with the final map of phasing out will be decided at the time of budget.
Right, but the still it is not completely done. I mean, given these exemptions, they are directed to, you are mentioning, you've given a list, they are directed towards a specific geographical location, or maybe the certain economical class, or maybe certain special class of section of people. If this is given, now there comes new demands. Few other people will come and then say, we even need the tax exemptions. How are you planning to tackle these problems?
Well, we can't completely eliminate exemptions. In fact, you would remember that recently only, we have announced one new exemption also for companies which are startups. The Prime Minister himself has said that for 3 years they will pay no income tax. So there are certain tax exemptions which may have to continue.
Right.
But there are others which can be reduced to the extent possible. And if we are able to reduce the number of exemptions and the amount we are losing in exemption, we would be in a better position to reduce our taxation structure and the taxation rate.
One crucial aspect that comes is there is a rising concern about this huge pendency of appeals that are actually clogging the complete judicial system at the tribunal stage itself. Now, government is said to be a compulsive litigant. And if an appeal may take several months, even years, in fact, to be actually concluded, in such a scenario, what exactly are the steps you've been taking to address this situation?
Well, the appeals are of two types. The litigation is of two types. One from the government to the government and the other one from the tax assessees. When it comes to income tax, there are a large number of litigations pending. We have got about 3.4 lakh litigations pending in various forums, starting from commissioner appeal to ITAT to High Court and Supreme Court. When it comes to indirect tax, the number of litigations are about 1.36 lakh litigations.
True.
In income tax, only 18% of the cases which are in litigation are filed by the department. And the remaining 82% are by the SSEs. In case of indirect tax, about 25% litigation is by the government, 75% is by the SSEs. The way to reduce litigation, we all agree we must reduce the litigation.
Yes.
And we are trying in that direction. In order to reduce the litigation from the department side, recently we have already announced that we will increase the threshold of tax effect for filing an appeal. So we won't go in appeal for smaller cases, we will only go in appeal for bigger cases. Because of this, we hope that the 50% of the appeals or the litigations which are from the department, they will be reduced in next 3 to 4 months.
True.
And we are also planning to sort of come out with some kind of a scheme by which we can reduce the litigation from the SSE side. And the main reason for litigation in income tax is because the penalty provision is very high. We have a penalty provision which says ke minimum 100% penalty, maximum 300%. And people don't mind paying the original sum, but they are very scared of paying this much of penalty. So many of the litigations are also because of the wrong kind of penalty, very high penalty rates which were prescribed in the Act. So these are the issues because of which the litigation is high. We all have to find ways and means to reduce the litigation, so that there is a relief all around, you know.
Right. And so we're talking about this litigation aspect and other important aspects. We look at the complete private investment factor, where in fact the finance minister Arun Jaitley was also mentioning. Let's link that to the taxation. If we have to provide a conducive tax regime for to increase more and more investments from the foreign countries, what exactly should be done in the future?
Well, we have to rationalize our taxation laws. We have to simplify them. We have to have predictability in tax regime. We have to have a kind of a certainty. Now, these are the things which are required when it comes to taxation.
Right.
Then the investor would be interested in coming to our country.
Right.
And there are also multiplicity of levies by the state government and the central government. And this is also causing a lot of compliance burden. And the only solution to this is GST. So GST should be able to solve this problem.
Absolutely. Right. And then when various economists as well, I just want your analysis on this. Various economists also say that India's tax receipts as a share of its economy need to be doubled in the next decade. Would you accept with this? And then if so, what exactly are the steps to be taken?
Well, we are having a tax GDP ratio, which is around 10%
now. 10% now, yes.
And there is a need for increasing the tax to GDP ratio, but we have to also see the capacity of our people to bear that kind of a taxation burden. But if we simply rationalize the taxation system and remove the exemptions, I'm sure the tax to GDP ratio can be enhanced substantially.
Right. And then let's talk about the budget process as well. Sir, enough. I just want your complete analysis on this budget process, and also how is the revenue side of the budget actually made?
Well, it's a huge process. We have been spending number of days in the office now. For the last 3 weekends, I've never gone to home. All the weekends we are working, all days we are working, every day up to 9 o'clock. We have representations coming from so many people for the budget. We analyze each one of those suggestions. We hold meetings with trade associations and various interest groups. And after that, we make some broadsheets in which we tabulate the various suggestions. Then there is a view taken at my level. And then we finally go to the finance minister, take all these problems to him. And then at his level, certain things are screened. And then finally, some proposals go to Prime Minister. And that is how the final budget is made.
Right. And then you were mentioning about GST. Administration-wise, how was the complete department ready, sir? We have other issues, but then administration-wise and the implementation
point of view? We are perfectly ready. And everything is done. In terms of IT system also, we have got complete readiness. The only question is, if the bill is passed, constitutional amendment bill is passed in the parliament, then we should be able to move ahead and make it a reality.
So from the administration point of view, you're completely ready to implement.
Absolutely, it passed. Absolutely.
And then when let's talk about the budget as well, sir. We talk about certain important aspects like Make in India. We talk about various other important aspects that lead to the economic growth of the country. We link it to the taxation. How exactly is this budget going to be, sir?
Well, taxation is a big instrument for spurring the growth. Taxation is also probably an instrument of promoting employment. Tax can also be an instrument for giving some kind of a protection to the local industry so that Making India is promoted. So all these missions could be achieved by way of budget.
Right. And finally, sir, what exactly you would like to say to the people of the country who are eagerly looking towards the budget? In fact, Finance Minister has said that this is not actually going to be a populist, but it would actually people-oriented. How are you looking at it?
Well, the focus of the budget should be on tax rationalization and simplification. And the focus should be on promoting growth, in promoting employment, and in terms of giving sort of a level playing field to the Indian domestic manufacturers.
True.
So that Make in India can happen.
So this is going to be a Make in India sort of a budget from the taxation point of view too.
Yes, apart from other things, it could be Make in India also.
Right. Thank you very much, Dr. Adhia, for giving your time indeed. So it was the Revenue Secretary of the Government of India, Dr. Hasmukh Adhia, talking about the taxation, both direct taxes and indirect taxes, and also the issues related to it on the backdrop of Union Budget 2016-17. Thank you for watching this show.